But it's 1979. I get an assignment from Newsweek magazine to photograph this author.
He doesn't like to be photographed, but we do know he picks up his mail in Windsor, Vermont. So I waited.
And then this Jeep pulls up, and he gets out, and he goes into the post office really quickly. And then as he came back out, I got it. I got Salinger.
The publication of Catcher in the Rye in 1951 was a revolution.
There had not been a voice like that.
When you're a kid and you read Catcher in the Rye, you're just like, oh my God, somebody gets it.
I remember that being the first book you take with you.
It is a phenomenon. How many millions and millions came to that book?
The great mystery is why he stopped.
Salinger was a national story, a shooting star.
At the height of that success, he disappears. He became the Howard Hughes of his day.
Mystery. We all like a mystery.
The Second World War created J.D. Salinger.
There was a lot of mystery about what he did in the Army.
Very few people have seen as much death.
Salinger suffered a nervous breakdown.
He's got this concrete bunker where he works.
He has a very fanatical readership.
If one person used something I had written as their justification for killing somebody, I'd say, God, people are crazy.
I was literally living inside of J.D. Salinger's A Catcher in the Rye.
But if three people used something I had written as justification, I would be very, very troubled by it.
He wanted nothing to come between him and his characters. They were real for him. He moved them about the stage like God.
You cannot dismiss the issues of his private life.
People heard him, people he trusted.
He said, "You have ruined my life."
I saw two manuscripts.
What's in that vault?
Someone cracks that code, man, it's going to be the story of the century.
Writing a book is a horrible, exhausting struggle. One would never undertake such a thing if one were not driven by some demon. And he had demons.